In video 18, we took the opportunity that the cylinder heads were disassembled to replace the pushrod tubes. With the cylinder heads out of the way, you can install standard pushrod tubes. There are different versions available. The length is different depending on the type of engine. Here we show an overview of the length of the pipes, or tubes, along with the year of manufacture and type of engine. The younger the engine, the more power, the longer the pushrod tubes are. This is the version for the 25 horsepower or 30 horsepower engine. These are the pipes for the 1200 engine with 34 horsepower. And finally these for the 1300, 1500, 1600 engines. You can also measure the distance between cylinder head and the crankcase, just to be sure, as confirmation before ordering. The standard pushrod tubes can be pulled out or pushed in on either side to adjust the length. It is best to pull them out to the maximum prescribed length, for example 191 mm for our AB1300 engine. While tightening the cylinder head, the pushrod tubes will naturally assume the correct length. We refer to video 17 of this series for more information on this. To install standard pushrod tubes on a Type 1 engine, you must disassemble the cylinder heads. Therefore, we recommend that you also disassemble the cylinders and put a new gasket between the cylinder and the engine crankcase. This is a lot of work, and you will probably encounter other problems, so a simple pushrod tube replacement may turn into a bigger project. If one or more pushrod tubes need to be replaced, there is another solution. With these adjustable pushrod tubes, you can quickly fix an oil leak without disassembling the cylinder heads. Please note, these spring adjustable pipes or tubes are not available for every type of engine. We'll now show you how it's done. But first, you need to remove the pushrods. We explained this in video 14 of this engine overhaul series. To remove the pushrods, you must first remove the rocker shaft. Once the pushrods are removed, you can loosen the pushrod tubes. The best way to do this is to cut them apart and then remove them with a gripper. The old tubes can be very tight between the cylinder head and the crankcase. By first removing the tension, by grinding them in the middle, disassembly usually goes very smoothly. In most cases, the rubber seals will be so hardened and discolored that they appear to be part of the cylinder head, but, of course, they are not. Here we show that on a disassembled cylinder head, the rubber is so hardened that it falls apart in pieces. When your cylinder head is still assembled, you have to be extra vigilant that pieces don't fall into the crankcase. Remember that the standard Type 1 engine does not have an oil filter. You prefer not to have those pieces of hardened rubber in your engine. So, carefully, clean both the cylinder head side and the crankcase side. Here you see all the parts for the set meant for the 1300, 1500 and 1600 engines. Each pushrod tube consists of one long and one short tube, two O-rings, two metal rings, two rubber seals and one spring. You can also order the rubber seals and the O-rings separately. Install the first O-ring on the shortest tube. You may use some glycerin or motor oil on the O-rings. Next, fit the second O-ring. Use the metal ring on the narrow end of the other tube and push the rubber seal onto it. The seal is tapered, the narrow end facing outward, and will later engage in the engine crankcase. Mount on the tube with the two O-rings, also such a metal ring with rubber seal. The spring fits into the longest tube. The shortest tube slides into the longest tube. This version has an end that goes deeper into the crankcase, also called windage. This allows the engine oil to stay in the crankcase better during sharp turns. So you have to install these spring adjustable pushrod tubes in the right direction. The side with the longest part beyond the rubber seal should be on the crankcase side. Check again that the mating surfaces into which the rubber seals fit are clean. Use glycerin to minimize the resistance of the rubbers. Lubricating the O-rings with glycerin or engine oil helps the two tubes slide over each other. The spring gives a fair amount of resistance, but can be pushed in by hand. You may replace one tube with a spring adjustable one, as we do here, and leave the other tubes in place. If the old pushrod tubes do not leak or are not damaged, you do not need to replace them either. Check that the rubber seals are properly positioned in the crankcase and in the cylinder head. The tube should not stick out on the cylinder head side. If it does, you have mounted them in the incorrect direction. Here you can see the end result. Spring adjustable tubes may be used together with standard tubes. This is sometimes a solution for a quick repair without having to disassemble the cylinder head and cylinders. In video 21, we will continue with the piston rings. We will show in that video how to disassemble piston rings and how to install new piston rings and what to pay attention to during the engine overhaul. More information about all the parts and tools used in this video series can be found as comments under each video on our YouTube channel. See you soon.